Hello everybody, it's Diana from Ionic Themes, and in this video I will talk about setting up your development environment in order to start building Ionic Framework apps. Also, I will show you how to unpack Ion2 full app, Ionic Template, and how to install all the dependencies required by the template. We will go through the process of browsing your Ionic project on your browser, and also I will show you how to use DevApp to load your Ionic app and to develop with live reloading on your devices. If you are new to Ionic Framework, check the previous video where I explain what Ionic Framework is and how you can benefit by using the templates we have created in Ionic Themes. So, let's start. Ionic apps are created and developed primarily through the Ionic command line utility, also known as the CLI, and use Cordova to build and deploy as a native app. This means that we need to install a few utilities to get developing. So, if you are new to Ionic development, please go to this page over here in order to see how to install Node and NPM, and then Ionic CLI and Cordova. So, I already have them installed in my computer, but I will show you how you need to do it if you don't have them. So, first you need to check if you have Node and NPM. So you will open a console or a terminal. I use Mac, so I use iTerm. So you will type node dash dash b, sorry, dash b to see the if you have it installed. I have it, so you will also see if you have npm. I already have them. In case you don't have them installed, just follow the steps from this link. After having installed NPM and Node, we will follow with Ionic and Cordova CLI. So, you have to type this on your terminal, and this will install both Ionic and Cordova, and it will install them globally, as it explains here. I also have them installed, so I will not do it, but you just need to copy this and paste it here, and it will do the rest alone. So, after you have all these dependencies installed, our development environment will be ready to start building Ionic apps. But as you may know, Ionic project itself needs some dependencies in order to work. So let's see how to install the dependencies of one of the Ionic starter apps we have here at Ionic Themes. Once you buy a template in Ionic Themes, you will get an email with a link to download a zip file which will contain all the source code of the template. So let's see, I will show you how it will look like. For example, here I have this Ion2 full app lead zip, and after unzip, this is the folder. So I will move it to, I will copy and move it to this other folder. So now here we can go to that folder where I put the code, Ionic videos, and the name is, you can change this name obviously. So now we are inside a folder of our Ionic project, so we need to install the dependencies needed by the project. I will open the project on a code editor. I use Atom, but you can use the one you like. So what I want to show you here is this project, this Ionic project has a package.json file where all the dependencies required by the project are defined here. You can see that in this case there are a lot, because this template is the most complete template that we have in Ionic Themes and has lots of integrations and libraries. Obviously, sorry, you don't need them all, but in case you want to use them, you have it here. So in order to install all of these, we have to run inside our project folder npm install. This can take a few minutes. All the dependencies got installed and we have this huge message. We will see that there is a node module folder and inside it has all the packages needed. Stay here. So we are ready to run this Ionic app on our browser. We will go here and run Ionic serve. This will build the project and then it will open our browser and the project will be live there. I will show you in a few seconds. So now, as you can see, our app is ready. It's being served on this port. So we will go there. It's here. We will change the view so we can view it as a mobile app. I use Chrome. What's happening here? No. So you can see this is the app we are working with. You can see that you can check it here, you can use it here. Please note that Cordova plugins will not be available here because we are in the browser and not on a real device. So here you can see, you can test the app and everything is beautiful. So we can also use the Ionic Dev app. I don't know if you are familiar with it, but it's, you can learn more about it here. You have to download this app. Here are the links, and install it on your phone. And with this app, you can run and test and build the Ionic app directly on your phone. I will show you in my phone how it looks like. So when you build your app with Ionic Serve, you will see this dev app and you will see this. So you have to go to your phone, open the app. I have it here. Open the app and it will automatically discover. You have to connect both your phone and your computer to the same Wi-Fi network. So the app can discover the apps that are being browsed in that Wi-Fi. So I have this one, Untitled Chapter. I will check it. After a few seconds, it will be ready for us to see it here. So this is the screen of my phone and I'm browsing the app, and you can also see that if we change anything, this will automatically will be reloaded here. For example, we can change the this text, sign up text. So let's go to the code, sign up, and look for that text. Oh, that's okay. That text is, yeah, because we have internationalization, so it's in this JSON file. So I will change it. I think it's, yeah. I will put test video and we'll save. So here you will see that it will get reloaded. This is on my phone. I will go again to that page. Here you can see test videos. So it was very fast. It's very easy to deploy apps this way. I use it a lot because sometimes, as you can see, the browser is a bit slow. I don't know, I prefer to see it on my phone. So in this video, we learn how to have everything ready to start customizing your apps, your Ionic apps. We show you how to configure the library load and also how to deploy your app to DevApp. In the next video, we will show you how to deploy your final app to iOS and Android devices. So it has not to be your final app, but you can deploy the app to your devices in order to check, to test the Cordova plugins, to see how everything works, and to have like a more real life scenario. So I hope you like this video, and see you in the next one. Bye.